so forth, there's seemingly the sun reverse polarity here. The minor sun that they thought they had time enough to work around and get away from began to send out signals so it would grow, and it went through what they call a sun cycle while they were working here. They seemingly had used some kind of a contraption to make themselves somewhat physical while working on this physical planet, and it caused them to change. It caused them to get more dense. For instance, again, as we here talked about, I'm going as best as I can to make a long, long story as short as I can, but still not to lose the audience. Whether you believe it or not is a whole different thing. But it's
well,
as though
you're doing an excellent job. I mean, it's very clear, and I appreciate it because you're breaking it down so that I can understand it.
And hopefully I can, too. So now, it means that these creatures now, if they made rock or begin to solidify physical corporeal reality, minerals, into a rock, they could put their minds into the rock and then understand what the rock was doing or what the rock needed, because they were the rock. If they made water, they were the water. Mm-hmm. If they made trees, they were the wood in the trees. But they were not those things because they could put their mind wherever they want to. In other words, that's what we talk about many times. Did you put your mind to it? See, we use certain phrases. Or they'll ask you again, well, where were you? Your mind was a million miles away. And, of course, they talk about the speed of light being 186,000 miles a second. But you can be in your mind anywhere you want. There is no such thing as speed or time when you use your mind. So this is what we've got to understand, the difference between physical reality, which is a oxymoron, there's no such thing as physical reality, or the mental comprehension of physical reality. This is where we have to go with this. So while here, the sun began to amplify, magnify, or whatever you want to say it, and they got frightened because they knew that that meant that if that sun energy was built for this particular planet and their minds were in it, their minds would be affected by this sun, and they might have to become locked into this place, and this is what they feared. So their comrades, I guess, which were holding fort in whatever they were doing out in space, saw this happening and started fleeing, like you might as well say, with crazy people. They left. And they left them without, I guess you might say, putting into the transporter or fixing up the guys that they left down here working. So they ran out and left them. And then by the time they were working deeply inside this physical contraption called a planet, by the time they got to the surface and I guess to beam aboard or do whatever they did, what they call actually traveling, what is referred to now as the, what do they call it? I can't think of the name they use for it now. But it's the, they were traveling with the Kabah. Oh, anyway, Kabah.
The
Merkaba. There we go. And that's the vehicle.
In other words, Scotty, who was there, supposed to beaming them up, supposedly there to beam them up, had left them.
Had left them, yes. And the vehicle that they were using was a combined thought vehicle. It was called the Merkaba. Okay?
Uh-huh.
The Mer means waves or flowing or energy flows. The Ka and the Ba is the soul and the mind. The soul and the brain, the Ka and the Ba. So they left with the overall Merkaba, leaving these individuals, Ka's, or spirits, stuck here. So because of that, they then got caught up in a more or less low vibrational human type of a thing. That's the best word I can use for right now to explain what human really means. So here they were. You might as well say fallen gods, a very advanced race of consciousness, here to make a planet, and got caught up in the planet or in the kindergarten or whatever it was they were working on. So this set up a long concept of a problem on this particular portal or planet or cell or whatever you want to call it we're on. So that's the way the story goes. So they became known as the abandoned ones, and they were referred to in history, in metaphysical history, as the abandero. The abandoned deros, and deros meant derogatory robotized organisms, but we'll have to wait for that too. But this is the set that sets this pace of a race or a whatever you want to call them, of people, of creatures or something that were not supposed to be here, are supposed to be the advance guard of very prolific in consciousness races that now are stuck on a planet like Earth. So they also knew that their life would be seeded here, and they were about the business of setting up this planet to get this life seed. They might as well.
They were stuck, so they...
Well, that's what they were supposed to do. So now they became a lost seed. Now they became a star seed. They became now part of the life form that was going to be growing up here, But now they weren't supposed to be going up here, but now they were stuck. And as the planet took on more density, they lost their minds. Now, you see, when you lose your mind, doesn't mean you lose your brain power. It means you lose a higher consciousness of universal mind connection, but now you become just like anything else, down to where the mental connection of that particular planet's grade is. If it's kindergarten, if it's first grade, second grade, third grade, high school, you know, wherever you want to go. So now they were in kindergarten.
This was a deep amnesia.
Call it that.
They forgot who they were.
Call it that.
Okay.
Either, all right, so that's your setting now. Now, because of having now deserted these fallen angels or gods, they also knew that they would do what they had to do, which would be to get off the surface of this planet, since they were building it, because that's where all the sun rays hit. And it's been stated in metaphysics that intelligent life does not live on the surface of a planet. Remember that. It lives in the interior of a planet because of the fact that you're not your own boss if you've got a sun, where we get the phrase, nothing new under a sun. Because suns are now these solar, they are now like guides. They're now like computer programs that are now running, and nothing new is going to come there. You only learn from that computer program. Whereas if you're an advanced race, you don't need a computer program. You make up your own computers. Can you follow my logic here now?
I see. I'm listening.
All right. All right. So now, here you have now this fallen race inside of an earth crust that is getting more dense, but they're still living down there in the bowels. Now, this particular planet was supposed to be set up with a nuclear cell, or what they would call, again, a soul, if you would. And again, remember, solar, soul, actually means a created energy close to the creator. Okay, so now, there was now a sun down inside of this place so that this planet could begin to live as a new cell, but it was still operated by the higher sun, and then other cells were being set up too later on. These are what they're now called planets. Now, with all of that in mind, they then, these ones that then left them, their comrades who got scared and left them, and as point guards get left out or as a platoon gets left out, they said, we got to do something. We don't know what we've done. We ain't going back there, but we got to do something. So they said that they then sent a soul that was made purposely to be sacrificed or sent as a god to these abandoned ones. And that particular incarnation was called Seth, and the term was called, his name was Sethantis. I shouldn't say him, because original people were androgynous. There was no such thing as sex. It was a being that was neither male nor female called Seth, or the name Sethantis. Now, if you go back to the Superman-type things, if you remember, this is the way that they said Superman was born. Okay? If you remember all the comic strips in the news, it was this guy came from a... Remember that, how that went?
I do.
Okay, so you might as well think of that same scenario. But the catch was, instead of Krypton and Kryptonite, he was given melanin. Now, melanin, therefore, is said to be a gift from the higher gods or the higher sources, because melanin was made of dark matter. And dark matter is the original matter, because from matter you can now get substance, and this is where you can get your suns, but it comes from the world of darkness, what they call dark matter. We're not even talking about dark holes yet, black holes. We've got to talk now about dark matter. And this person was given a serum or something that once he got to the planet Earth and he opened up this particular device that he was in, or this soul was in, they were to administer over a length of time this dark matter into him. So the first original person on Earth that was black would be Seth, Sethantis. But understand the meaning of that. It meant that the serum he was given, or the plasma that he was given, or the substance that he was given, allowed, which was now called melanin, allowed him to now live on the surface, in the air, or in the interior. It meant he could be extraterrestrial, terrestrial, or interterrestrial. We've lost sight of understanding interterrestrial. We're just beginning to say terrestris, which is one of the names for Earth, too. It has many names, and then extraterrestrial. But this is how you begin to get these nomenclatures called X, N, and inner, if you would. So with that in mind now, to govern and help the abandoned ones, the abanderos, the ones that were left again, Seth then became like a giant that could be cosmic. He could relegate, he, well, he,